In this video, I will discuss a straightforward method for reusing McGrath video laryngoscope batteries. Due to recent production problems with McGrath batteries, which are produced overseas, batteries have been intermittently available for purchase. Because it is the primary video laryngoscope of my institution, as well as many others, and it is a vital tool during the COVID crisis that we cannot be without, I wanted to ensure that we would not lose access to this vital tool due to battery unavailability. Warning, this information is presented for educational purposes only. Do not modify medical devices without consultation with the manufacturer. Any modification of an FDA-approved medical device may invalidate the FDA approval, and the manufacturer will likely absolve themselves of liability in the event of device malfunction and patient injury. Items that you will need to reuse a McGrath battery pack. Used battery pack. New 3.6 volt AA lithium battery cell. Note that this is not the standard 1.5 volt battery cell ubiquitously used in consumer electronics. However, these battery cells can be purchased online for $2 to $3 each. Razor blade. Small screwdriver. Cell phone with near-field communication capabilities. Cell phone app for NFC reading and writing. Even if you don't use the function, your smartphone probably has NFC capabilities if it was made in the last 2 to 3 years. I'll be using an iPhone XS for this video and a free app called NFC Tap. I'll also be using a brand new battery for demonstration purposes, but you will not need a brand new battery to follow this guide. Start by cutting the battery cell out of the back of the battery pack. Remove the paper wrapping and gently pry out the old battery cell as not to damage the housing. Replace the old battery cell with a new one. I don't know that the paper casing has any purpose, but I placed that back as well. If we insert the battery pack back into the McGrath and press the power button, we see that the battery pack powers the laryngoscope, but still reads as empty. This is because the number usually shown at the bottom of the screen is not a battery meter, but a preset counter that starts at 250 minutes and counts down to 0 minutes, regardless of battery level. In order to reset the battery counter, we are going to take the data from the RFID tag of a brand new battery and write it to the old battery, essentially resetting the counter to 250 minutes as if it was a brand new battery. First, I'll hold the battery pack against the NFC reading region of my phone and open the NFC app. On this particular app, press Read Tag to read the chip and calibrate the app to the correct communication protocol. On some apps, you will need to set the protocol manually. The protocol is ISO 15693. We'll then go to the Memory tab and press Read, Read Multiple Blocks, and Start. This will give us the data we need in Block 0 and Block 1. The rest of the blocks are not needed. Now that we have the block info we need, start the process again with your used battery pack. Open the app, press Read Tag to calibrate the app to the correct communication protocol. To see for yourself that block 0 and block 1 are different in the used battery, go to Memory, Read, Read Multiple Blocks, Start. See that block 0 and block 1 have different values compared to the new battery. Now go back to the Memory tab and hit Write, Write Single Block. To block 0, write 2A030003. Press Start. Now you can return to the Read tab to verify that block 0 has been written. Now to finish, go back to the Write tab and write 8 zeros to block 1. You can go back to Read and verify success in block 1 if you like. Now place the battery pack into your laryngoscope and press power. This time, the laryngoscope is functional. We can see here that the battery counter has returned to 250. Use your battery pack as normal, and when the battery pack is depleted, simply perform the process again. One additional question that I did not explore is, can the 250-minute counter be reset without replacing the battery cell? That is, how much time is left on the battery when the counter reaches zero? Can one simply reset the counter and get another 250 minutes out of the counter? Because the replacement battery cells are so inexpensive, and blindly resetting the counter might lead to the device shutting off during intubation, I chose not to explore this concept. Hope this guide was helpful. Thanks for watching.